Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. So today I have my husband Elvis here with me because we got so many questions about how we raised our daughters, even though there's a lot to cover.
It'd be basically impossible to cover in one video, but we're gonna try our best.
Yes, we're gonna start with our background because if you know anything about parenting, it has everything to do about the way you were raised. So we're gonna talk about that.
Yeah, like Susanna has a completely different background than I did. We kind of came together and decided to do the best for our kids. There's a very important event that happened throughout this. Susanna and I became the first generation in our families to follow Christ.
Yes.
You know, to believe in the God of the Bible, to be, you know, a born again believer.
Yes.
Right? So we're the very first generation in our families, and that carries like it's a good burden, right?
Yes.
We're very happy that we are able to do that. Now that we know, we take that as a huge blessing to our family,
you know,
that we got to raise our kids, you know, under God's guidance. That is something that is priceless.
Yeah, even though we're not perfect by any means.
Like a disclaimer, right? We are not by any means, we want to say that this is how you should parent,
yeah.
Right? This is how you should raise your kids, because there are a lot of parenting out there that also do like an amazing job. There's so many amazing kids out there. This is like our experience, right? Because you guys know Milena and Melanie.
Yes.
So you asked questions, you know, how they were raised.
Yeah.
So by any means, we didn't go to any parenting courses.
No.
Or we didn't graduate in parenting, you know, university or anything like that, right? We didn't read any books until later on when they got to teenager years. Let's see how we raise teenagers. No, it was nothing like that, correct?
Yes, yes.
Right when we became parents, it's actually when we came to know Christ.
Yes.
So there's
Milena was 6 months old.
Yeah, so it's like two parallels, right? We like raising kids on our old selves, right? Whatever
yes.
we knew from my background and her background.
Yes.
And then learning to walk with God.
Yeah.
And like through Susanna's Bible study groups that she joined and my Bible study groups that I've joined, you know, we were learning about God.
Yeah. And we're on a journey. It was like for us was like two journeys, right? Being a parent and being Christian and mingle those together.
Yeah.
Right? So we had to learn.
Yeah.
You know, we had to learn a lot, and I love to say that once we became Christians that everything changed. No. If you know anything about being a Christian, it's a journey. It's a lifetime journey that every day you're learning and you're
learning to trust God,
yeah.
You know, faith.
You make mistakes and then you learn from those mistakes.
Yeah.
Right?
That's when God's grace comes into play, right? When
yeah,
we
exactly.
make mistakes and you go back to Him, hey God, I grew up again,
yes.
you know, for the 10th time,
yes.
this morning, you know, please guide me, you know, because
yeah.
I can't do this, you know, help me, give me something, you know, what should I do? That helped us a whole bunch, right?
Yes,
to raise
it did.
Our kids.
It did.
At least we had like a standard to follow, right? Where do we go to learn how to raise our kids, right?
Yes.
There's no like a right book. I'm pretty sure there are tons of books out there, but for us, that was like okay, let's see what the Bible has to say about this, right?
Yes. Of course, we're going to talk about our background and the things that we did and the things that we didn't do. But before that, we just know and we just want to thank God for the things that He has done. Because we know it was His grace that, you know, Milena and Melanie are the women of God that they are today. Grounded and such a good heart and bring so many people to Christ also. So we know it's Him. We completely know it's His hand all over it.
We truly believe that, you know, if there is anything good in me or anything good in Susanna, it's because of God's grace, right? And if there is anything good in Milena and Melanie, it's because since they were little, you know, Susanna and I prayed with them every night.
Yes. We always prayed for their future
yes.
husbands,
their
future in general, you know?
Yeah.
Always. So we know it has something to do with that, but ultimately it's God, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
So a little bit of our background. I'm going to say my background first. And
what I'm
going to
learn today that I don't know. Let's see.
So, as you know, we're from Brazil. So, of course, we were raised in Brazil. And in my family, you know, there wasn't a lot of rules. I mean, I kind of grew up doing whatever I wanted, whatever time I wanted. Because of that, I made a lot of mistakes. And because of it, I brought a lot of baggage to our marriage, which is not fair. So because of it, I learned from it. I learned, like, I'm not going to do the same with my daughters. This is something that I didn't want to happen to them. So that's the reason why we're kind of strict. So I'll let Elvis tell his side of the story.
What you did not want to happen to your daughters?
They to do whatever they want. Because when you're a teenager, you, even though you think you know everything, you don't. And then you go and do things that you shouldn't do, that will affect your life. You know, we want to have like a guideline for them.
Yeah. It's like, I was talking to Susanna the other day, it was very funny. Because Susanna, I don't remember my parents ever sitting down with me and telling me, you know, you should not do this. You know, they're like, they're very good parents. You know, my father always provided for our family. He was like, you know, he worked like three jobs. My mom was always taking care of, you know, we were like three boys, right? Driving her crazy, you know. But I don't remember them like sitting down with us.
No, no rules.
Yeah. What I remember is like my mom, you know, hitting me like, hey, you shouldn't do that. I'm like, okay, I didn't know I couldn't do that. So, you know, I learned the things I shouldn't be doing on the day of, after I've done it. So
there wasn't any like conversation as a family or, oh, we expect this or we don't want you to do that. Or, he said, it's not that they were bad parents.
No,
it's just
absolutely
the reality
not.
In Brazil is different than here.
Well, and maybe that generation, right? They were concerned about...
They're concerned about providing.
Yeah,
you know,
that was
providing
very hard.
For us.
Correct.
And
their thinking was, I'm providing you food, school, and clothes.
Yes.
You're good. You're golden.
You do your part.
Yeah. Which, you know...
Kind of makes sense, right?
Makes sense. That, you know, on that generation, right? We cannot... Yeah. Now we're...
Transfer.
Yeah, we are completely new generation, right? Things change from generation to generation, right?
Yeah.
So, respect, right?
Yeah. So, one of the things that were very, like... We were strict with them. We didn't let them do whatever they want.
Or tell us whatever.
Yeah, and one thing was like we never seek to be their friends. We were parents, and we want respect, not just for us, but also for others. You know, especially older people. We never took any
crap.
Yeah, we never took that. You know, from them, and they knew it.
Yeah.
They knew it.
Yeah, they knew it.
Even though there's nothing wrong, like today, I love to be their friends, you know?
Yeah.
But there is, in my opinion, okay,
and
when they're growing up, like as a preteen and teen, you have to be the parent. You know, I think this is missing today, unfortunately.
Yeah. I mean, we're always loving parents. Oh my God, we will do anything for them. You know, we will do anything for our kids. I think we're trying to say we're not like friends at their age that they would come and tell us and we would just agree with them and say everything is okay. Now, we always looked and talked to them from the parenting point of view, right?
Yes.
Trying to save them headaches, right? You know, if you do this, and we always did a lot of what ifs with them, right? We did a lot of conversations, you know, what if, you know, what if somebody offers you a drug? What are you going to do, you know?
Yeah.
You know, if you start drinking, then you're going to try pot.
Yeah.
Then you're gonna try something stronger. So when you think about alcohol and just a little puff on a pot, things like that, that's bad to begin with because that's the beginning of a domino effect that will lead you to a life of destruction. So we always try to teach them that, right?
Yeah.
And I think I'm not saying that they never did anything wrong.
Of course they did.
But the point is, the moment that somebody offered them drugs, they knew the difference.
They knew. So if they accepted, they were taking a risk.
It's their choice.
They knew and they knew to hide it too.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think Milena and Jordan and Melanie did a podcast
about
they
addressed it.
They were caught.
That's funny. Yeah,
so,
they were caught.
Another thing, they go through phases. They go through phases that there's nothing that you can do but pray. And you just put on God's hand. So one more thing that I know, that's why I tell you, I know is God. He was always behind them.
Yeah.
Okay, another thing that I used to do when they were young, I used to use the rod to...
Not the rod, like what?
If you don't know anything about the rod is like, it's famous in the Bible. It's like what you use to discipline a child. Of course, you're not going to spank them on the head.
No, it's like a little twig.
It's like a little bit on the butt. And I used a few times, and most of the times was on top of the fridge as a, you know,
reminder.
As a reminder. So I would say, I'm going to get the rod. That helped too, right? It helped with their behavior and to listen
sure
and obey.
Parents in the house.
So
once in Leeds.
So they never had like the latest whatever was out. We always told them to like make a list, and then when it was, you know, Christmas or birthdays, you know we get like one
didn't
or
have,
two.
You know, they didn't have like Uggs every day, but they had their, you know, their books
they
that
had.
They liked.
They had.
You know, it was, let's say, metered. You know, we talk to them, we can get to this other thing here, which is good as, it, you know, it doesn't have the brand that you wanted, and, you know, put in your Christmas list, we might get to.
We also gave them things that they needed. Like, that was our present, right? As a kid.
Right.
I remember getting clothes or getting underwear and socks and things like that for Christmas and birthdays, because that's what we needed. So, we did that to them too. We gave them clothes and like one or two things that they want,
Some fancy things.
Yeah.
You know, and, you know, they always had their phones. What, they were not like the latest and greatest, but
no.
We know that they need it, you know, in case they need to talk to us. So, you know, they always had that. But it's always like on the more like a need against a want. So
yes.
We try to make sure that, okay, is it something that you want or is it something that you need? If it's something that they need, we'd go a long ways to make sure that they had it. If something that they want, if we could as parents,
And I think that
grounded
them.
Sometimes,
that grounded them because,
you know,
there's nothing to show off, really. But another thing that we always did since they were super little, of course, is go to church. Not to say that we talked about God or we're preaching today all day long. No, we're just regular parents trying to do our best. But one thing that we always did was go to church. They attend the kids' room, and we went to the service. After that, we went for dinner. We kind of made like a routine, a weekly weekend routine, church and go out.
And we know at the church there are young people or
adults. They are gifted.
Adults.
They are
gifted to deal with kids and, you know, and tell about God to them. So we made sure that we took advantage of that, of having these people available to us at church. That was like a blessing because a lot of things we didn't know how to do it. So we kind of relied on other people to do that because those are the tools that we had. So let's say, you know, let's use this tool. If the kid's not listening to us, maybe they were listening to a different person.
Yeah, they were amazing.
You know, they always had like summer trips. We made sure that we registered them.
Yeah, to Spring Hill.
Yes.
It's like a summer camp.
Yeah, where like different churches go to. So that's something that paid off because they get to spend weekend with other kids. And, you know, they have fun too, right? It's not only, you know, Bible, God, and stuff like that. Because they know, you know, kids are growing, right? They're like a sponge. So they would mix fun, adventure, and, you know, putting, you know, the Word of God, right? In everything they did and they experienced. So,
Also, us, we are always involved in church. You know how it is. Kids, they don't do what we ask. They do what we do, right? So they at least they could see by example, right? That we're always trying to be involved in some kind of ministry from our church.
Italia.
We have the hospitality gift and we love kitchen. So we always were doing something, either with soup kitchen or dinners. And of course, they were always involved with us. So they grew up seeing that, you know, going to church, being involved, and helping others somehow.
I think there was, now that we look back, there was, because we have that gift of hospitality, it makes easier, right? So, and everyone has different gifts, but we are using our gift to help other people, right? With, you know, getting involved with the church. So they presenced,
they
you know, they witnessed that of us serving, and you know, we would have people over, would cook like spaghetti to raise money, you know, for kids in Africa for clean water, or we would run marathons, and you know, to raise money for kids, and you know, they would watch us training, you know, for months, you know, and calling people and you know, having people over and asking for money so we can sponsor kids. But there was God in us,
yes,
right?
Of course.
That changed our hearts to do those, and the kids saw that. So it's like God ministering to our kids through us, that you know, we decided to make ourselves available to do that. So
yeah.
That I think that sometimes actions are more powerful than words.
Yeah, they do what we do,
you know,
not what we say.
I think that helped.
I think it was a little seed. Right?
Yeah.
It was a planted seed for sure.
It is, because once they became teenagers, they start going to now their own mission trips, right? To Haiti and like to states in the south, hurricane seasons, you know, after the hurricane, churches in the south would partner with the churches here in Michigan, and they would like send people over there to help their community. So we saw go, you know, we just say
yeah.
Go, you know,
we
want to make sure that we sign them up and say go, because we know something good would come out of it, right?
Yes.
For them to go there and not worry about themselves and worry about other.
Another thing that we always did was like sit down to eat dinner every single night.
Yeah, you know, that was a good thing,
yeah,
that we did that.
To,
yeah,
right? Every night we sit down to eat, we prayed,
mm-hmm.
and then we talked about.
Yeah.
The day, sometimes we didn't.
Yeah,
sometimes
we were so tired, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Well, it was just, we don't think we did anything special, you know. We did little things like this, and because you guys asked, we're like, okay, let's remember what we did. So this was one of the things that we did every single night.
Yeah.
Food, bring people together,
yeah,
right? So
yeah.
This is a time where you can just mingle and talk about something or nothing, and
yeah.
It's just, you know, nice.
Yeah, yeah. And you know, and Susanna brings the fact of, you know, sitting together for dinner and listening to the kids. I remember like at the very beginning, like middle school and high school, I wasn't a very good listener. And you know, it's reality. I'm a man. I'm, you know, I didn't think I need to listen to them. But then Susanna, a little bit, said, no, Elvis, you need to sit down and not say anything. Just listen.
Yeah.
Just listen to them so you can see what they're thinking. So then you can, you know, participate. Even if they say something that, you know, bugs you and you're tempted to, you know, to talk back, just be quiet and listen, you know? So later on, I kind of learned more.
It's the learning process.
Yeah, yeah. But
always...
I give her credit for, you know, letting me know, hey, you know, you have to listen. Just be quiet, just sit, and let them speak.
Another thing, also, we didn't let them sleep over at any friend's house. I think there were like two families that they were allowed to sleep over. And the reason for that is that I knew then and now that like 80% of abuse is by someone that the child know.
Yeah.
So I was just afraid because they had so many friends, and I just didn't know the mom. I just didn't know the family. So I didn't feel, you know, comfortable
yeah.
letting them sleep
yeah.
there. And they knew already. So,
but
because of it, we had a lot of people sleeping because I didn't let them sleep in their house, but
yeah.
they were welcome to come to our house.
Yeah.
So it was almost every weekend.
Every weekend.
And almost
somebody.
Every day, some kind of friends were there for
yeah.
dinner or just there, you
so
know?
We had a lot of young kids that were friends
yeah,
of ours.
Yes.
We would cook them breakfast, you know.
Yeah.
At night we'd do like fun stuff, movies, popcorn, and just
yes, we,
you know, load them with fun
really
stuff.
We welcome them because
yeah.
we want them to have friends, but
yeah.
we, you know how it is. If you're a parent, you know how it is.
Hey.
They were beautiful, beautiful girls,
yeah,
as you can see, as you guys know.
Yeah.
So I said, no, I wasn't just, they didn't like it, but eventually they got used to it. We had a lot of kids in the house, and
yeah.
with that we met a lot of their friends. So it was, I love it. You know, we
mm-hmm.
have very good memories with
so,
that.
So, well, that's something that we chose to do.
Yeah.
Right? Because
Milena didn't even ask. Melanie was more like
yeah, I want
nagging.
It. Yeah.
Milena, she was already, if the friend asked, I said, I can't, but you can come to my house.
Yeah.
Melanie was like, mom, can you please?
Yeah. But they did sleep over.
Some
friends'
some
house,
families,
yes.
Some families,
but,
no.
Yeah,
no.
But people that we know and trust.
Another thing that we always did too is travel together. They always traveled with us. I remember that I think they were 11 and 13 years old, and we went to this very nice resort in Jamaica. Remember?
Yeah,
it was a very good deal with those all-inclusive resort in Jamaica. And of course, the four of us, you know, went. And I remember a friend of ours, they came and said, are you guys gonna go alone? I said, no, you know, the girls are coming with us. They're like, why? And I was like, why not?
They're family. What kind of question is that?
We never took a vacation by ourselves.
No.
Our first vacation was when they left the house, right?
Yeah, like 2 years ago.
2 years ago was our first vacation without them.
Yeah.
So they were included in everything.
So they always traveled with us because during travels there were, you know, issues like we have to overbook something or something, you know, went wrong and we had to talk to people and solve issues. So they were there to see how we would behave, right? Because we're trying to be nice to other people, right? That's something that we're learning, you know, always respect other people, motivate people, always bring the best of people, right? So they're always there with us, you know, watching what we're doing, right?
Yeah. Even like restaurants, right? How we treat
restaurants,
waiters,
you know, we always love, you know, people who serve us. We always generous with tips and things like that, right? Those little things.
Being kind, right? Being kind and thank you and, you know, appreciative, not thinking that we are better than them or...
You know, those are things that we are learning, right? Also.
So we also, one thing that we also had was rules about dating.
When they start thinking about dating, about that time, there was like a ministry that our church introduced to us.
Yes.
It's called the Silver Ring Thing.
Yeah.
It's a ministry that targets young people, boys and girls, in how they can biblically save themselves for marriage.
Yes.
People are like, oh, this is cool because, you know, we don't have to do all the talk. You know, they can go there and listen to the talk. And I think there's a very young, talented team of people
who can
reach, you know, young people and talk to them about it. So we made sure that we registered them to go and watch.
And they're all over the United States.
At the end of the seminar, where the service.
Right?
Yeah, it's like a service. You know, they can get to wear a ring, so the girl wear a ring, and so is the father. It's like a commitment to be pure. You know,
until marriage.
Yeah, she has to commit to me that she's gonna be pure until she gets married, and then, you know, she gives the ring back to me
when she gets married.
And, you know, funny, interesting story. Like Milena got married to Jordan, I took my ring and gave to Jordan. So one day he can wear the ring with Tuki and Melanie as well.
Yeah.
So that's one thing that, you know, you have to keep watching. You know, there's so many ministries out there
that help us.
That helped us a lot. Yeah, there's one that it happens in Georgia every year.
The Passion.
It's called The Passion. So we made sure that, you know, it was a lot of money, but we paid so they could go,
yes,
you know, with church and be there. And they'll text us, God, Dad, Mom.
That was life-changing,
this speaker, you know, amazing. We promoted and we made sure that they always got involved in these things.
Yeah.
I think it's, you know, we have to rely on so many wonderful ministries that are out there,
yeah,
you know, that do things better than we do, right?
Yeah.
You know, they
and they'll listen better than they listen to us also.
Yeah, at times. So you have to use strategies.
Yeah.
You know, you need to see.
You have to search and see.
You know, search and see, okay, what can I do that, you know, if they'll listen, you know, to these people, I'm going to make sure that they go there and listen to these people, right?
Yeah.
So you do your research, you make sure that the message that they're giving is based upon the Bible. You know, you have some references and things like that, so you can...
Yeah.
You know, send them over. So
that's
like tools, right? You need to have tools.
Yeah. And then when they start to date, like Milena, when she started dating Jordan, and Melanie, she didn't have a lot of boyfriends, but we always had the talk.
Yeah.
Right? With the boyfriends and to tell them what we expect, you know? So it was kind of scary for some boyfriends.
And half of the boys didn't come back the next day.
So they didn't have a lot, like Milena had only, I think Milena, like a serious boyfriend, was only Jordan. And Melanie, I don't think she never had a serious boyfriend, but she had one boyfriend here and there, and we also had the talk. So this is something that we had to do, you know, we had to talk to them and tell them what we expect for the relationship.
Yeah, yeah. And
while they're living in our house, there was rules, yeah, and we expect them to be followed.
Yeah.
So.
And how important was for that part of the, you know, relationship with the a person, right? How important, you know, purity is, or
yes,
you know, sex, how intimate and how important that is completely lost in today's society.
Yeah.
Right? So we wanted to at least give them a different perspective, you know, what you hear in school and high school, it's
yeah,
not, we should not be part of your life,
yeah,
should not be in your relationship or in your marriage.
When we became Christians, we came to learn that, you know, when you are with someone, you know, intimately, it's not something physical only. It's like a soul thing. So this is serious stuff. So we always told them that. Yeah, and also Milena, she even did that. I don't know if it was a YouTube video or if it was a podcast where they talked about the rules. You know, they wouldn't stay alone inside the house. They had their own rules about it too.
Oh, hello.
So,
I think it's the most important.
Yeah,
isn't
praying.
It?
I mean, we had to learn how to pray, right? And we had to trust and that, you know, prayer is like a relationship with God, right? So we had difficulties, you know, praying at the beginning because we know any better.
But we learned.
But we know
the
prayer
of
a
righteous person,
you know, is heard. So, and so we always believe that a prayer of a
not
parent.
Not that we're perfect. But
yes.
Our heart works.
Yes.
Right? Our heart was good.
And we always pray with a sincere heart, right? So we would pray with them every night, right? That, you know, that they would do good in school.
Yeah.
That they would be amazing women of God when they grow up.
Yeah, for their future
husband. Like constantly praying, even, you know, when we are not with them, we are praying for them. So
yeah.
I think if you don't know where to start, I think praying is the very first step. That they're gonna grow up to, you know, to serve God, honor God, and, you know, represent God, so that other people will see the love of God through them.
Yeah.
You know, very simple
we always also
things.
Pray. Yeah, we always remember that praying, like, God, we want them in your will. We want them to do what you have for them, right?
Yeah.
Because all of us have a purpose, so
yes,
we always pray, like, God, please, you know, guide them to your will and for your purpose. And since they were babies, actually,
yeah, yeah,
since they
yeah
were very young,
yeah,
I remember being,
yeah,
you know, in the middle of their beds and and pray. And we see today, right?
Yeah.
We see the prayers being
answered.
The
power of prayer.
Yeah,
yeah,
we
yeah
see.
Yeah.
And another thing, we were not perfect whatsoever. We had our moments where we had arguments and we yelled in front of them. But even with that, I think they, you know, in their hearts, they knew that we were family, imperfect, but
yeah,
we loved them, you know.
They were committed to each other
as
parents.
Yeah, we were together as a family.
Yes. You know, we're family, right? We're not perfect, but we're, you know, we're together.
A real family.
Yes.
You know, we
you
have
know
arguments.
Yeah.
So
I'm pretty sure if I could go back to be a parent, I would do several things different.
Isn't it all of us?
Yeah, all of us. But
guilt is real and is part of it.
One thing that is paramount that Susan and I did as parents is that, number one, we were first generation Christians, right?
Yeah.
And we got to introduce them to God.
To Christ.
Yes.
Yeah.
If they choose not to, it's up to them. But we as a parent, we can rest every night and say, you know what? We did our part. We introduced them to God.
Yeah.
We showed them who God is. We took them to places where people talk about God. We got them involved
with people.
We tried to select friends that would build each other, right? You know, we tried to hook them up with the other kids that had the parents with the same thinking. And, you know, actually, Milena met Jordan like in a Bible study group. Right?
Bible study that she didn't
want to
go.
That she did not want to go. Milena did not want to go to Bible study. She goes, no, you gotta go. You're going.
Well, thank you. It was a lot of work too, because I remember she was in gymnastics, so I had to go pick her up at gymnastics, take her to Bible study, go home, fix dinner, whatever, and then go pick her up. So it was a lot of work for us, but it was so worth it. And I'm sure she can tell it's worth it too.
Where did she meet her husband? Bible study group, right?
So I think Bible studies or any kind of gathering with church is so important.
Yep.
You know, if you can take one thing from it, take that. You know, involve them in churching and in church and with people at church. You know, like friends from church and like, you know, I think that's...
Get together with the, you know, with the common, you know, subject. Yeah. And, you know, the Bible says that iron sharpens iron. And we truly believe that, like, you know, like even Jordan, right? Jordan was always more advanced in the Word of God, right? Because he, you know, he was born with that fire, you know, loving God. So it was a good thing that Melanie Milena was always with him, because we knew he would spur them, you know, to love God. And, you know, that's like an investment that, you know, you should be aware of. You know, who do your kids get with?
Yeah.
You know, make sure that they are with people who, you know, are more advanced. And
He influenced not just Milena, but Melanie too.
And us, you know, even today, Jordan, you know, influenced us, you know, the way he speaks and the way he loves God, you know. So, you know, we always, you know, this is a...
It's all blessings.
Yeah,
is all blessings.
Yeah. You know, Suzanne is the most loving mom. She has, you know, the heart of a mom for sure. And, you know, she always had more, let's say, sense when things were getting out of control. She'd be the one that, you know, calm things down. And, you know, she's the one who know the girls better than I do. So she always been in the mix, right, of our relationships. She always, you know, pitches in, you know, Elvis, you know, you should talk to Melanie like this because, you know, she'll listen to you, or, you know, talk to Milena like this because she'll listen to you. So we as a parent always have to rely on each other, right? So we're,
it's a teamwork.
Yeah, we, you know, we need to help each other. So that's one thing that we need to consider. We are a parent as a team. You know, if Susanna said something to them, I need to stick to what she said, even if I didn't agree to, right? And same thing, you know, if I say something, Susanna, within the reason, you know, would stick with me, so we didn't give them mixed messages.
Yeah, we try. I mean, we're, by any means, we're, like I said before, we're not perfect in this, and we learned a lot as we, you know, were raising them, and I'm sure we did a lot of mistakes, and they know that, but I think at the end of the day, our hearts, you know, was like at the right place, even though we kind of didn't know what to do sometimes. And another thing too is that like guilt is a real thing for a parent. And after the girls left the house, I started to feel a lot of guilt. You know, I don't know if it was the enemy saying things in my mind, but I just had to talk to them. You know, I talked to both of them, and I just asked them for forgiveness for the things that I should have done or the things that I didn't do. And I promised them that from now on, I will do, you know, my best, you know, to do a better mom. And that's what I have been doing. Elf did the same thing.
Yep.
And another thing too, also the girls had their moments. They had their moments where they didn't want anything to do with us. They didn't want anything to do with Christ, with the church. They just want to go out and do their thing. And so those are the times where we pray harder, and there's not much to do but pray and, you know, fast. Both of them, I really truly believe that both of them, they are grounded and they are being blessed right now in their lives, because there were moments in their life where they had to make a decision. Because we kind of gave them
the
foundation.
The tools,
the tools. But we are not there with them all the time, right? So there were moments in their life that they had to choose, you know? Thank God they knew. They knew what to choose. They know the right and they knew the wrong. Yeah. And I truly believe that they chose the right.
Yeah.
Because the blessing today and they being grounded in Christ is their decision.
And you know, they love God today. It's just like amazing. You know, at their age, we're not even
oh my gosh
thinking about God or anything like that.
No.
So that's like amazing that at their young age, you know, they talk about God and, you know, they respect and they honor God. And,
yeah,
you know,
they bring they
wanna,
a lot of people to God.
Yeah, they, you know, they want to do the right thing. So, you know, that's a complete blessing that, you know,
oh
they're doing that on their own. It's like, wow.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's like beyond our
imagination.
Yeah,
that's why we know. That's why we know.
Yeah.
Like, we did these little things that we told you, but
God got a hold of them.
God got a hold of their heart.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and they got a hold of God because, like I said, they listened and they obeyed. And I think that's obedient. It's, I think, it's the most important thing.
The beating heart. I think one of the important things also when we prayed is that, you know, we all say, God, you know, they're your kids first before they're ours.
Yes,
we
exactly.
always put them in God's hands. Say, God, here are our kids. Please, you know, be in their hearts.
Take care of
them. Be with them whenever they need to make a decision, right? So we always pray that, you know, that God and, you know, the Holy Spirit are with them when they come to a like a fork in the road and they have to make a decision. Please, God, just help them to make a good decision.
And they did.
They did, yeah.
And they did.
I mean, not all of them, because we know some of the stories now.
No,
you know?
No. I mean, like I said, they had their moments. They have kind of years where they were doing their thing, but we are always praying, you know, like at that time. And then when came the time for them to make the decision, they did. And we see the blessing now from that decision, you know. Looking back now, I really see three things. So looking back now, I really see like three things. Number one, I see God and God's intervention, you know, in their hearts, in their lives. I see us as a parent praying and trying our best to guide, even though, like I said, we are not perfect. And three, I see them making decisions because, like I said, we were not there. So they had to make the decisions with the things that they knew was right. So I think the combination of these three things is the fruit of what we see today,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah. You know, if you don't know where to start, if you're overwhelmed, praying is the best way to start because God will guide us, you know, always. You know, when you pray with a sincere heart, He will lead you what you need to do.
God is so faithful.
Yeah, and you just need to be obedient, you know, and parenting, oh my God, it's so hard, but so rewarding in the same way.
It is rewarding, and about the prayer, I think, like, you have to pray and be patient and wait, because sometimes can be like a month and maybe a year or two until
you see.
Or 5 years, until you start to seeing any, like, light at the end of the tunnel.
If you see, because it has to be God's will.
Yeah.
If it's God's will, right? Because we pray, oh, okay, God, you know, I pray that, you know, this happens and this happens. If it's God's will, it will. If it's not, it's not going to happen. You just need to be ready to, you know, to open doors and close doors.
Because He has a purpose, right?
Yeah.
He has a purpose for everything. And He may use people that they know, or they may use a song or TV to talk to, you know, to your kids. He's God. He can use anything to touch the person that you are praying for. Prayer, I think, is the most important thing, and not just for them, praying for their environment, praying for whoever is their friends, because it influenced them a lot, right?
Yeah.
Praying for good friends, godly and good friends, because they will help them with decisions.
Yeah, get them involved in ministry, help them see that there are, you know, other people with different backgrounds that need, you know, with needs, right?
Yeah.
You know, so they can develop like a soft heart. Right, for people.
Like a serving heart,
right? You know, like a serving heart. Let them see that they can be the hands of God, you know, to do the things that need, you know, to be done, you know, to help other. You know, even if the person has a gift of, you know, speaking or being a shoulder, that's ministry.
Yeah.
You know, if you can talk to people, you know, it's like, it's amazing, you know, like the body of Christ is made of so many components, you know, there's so many different gifts. That can be used, you know, to serve God. You know, make sure that your kids use their gifts, you know, to do what they need to do to serve God.
To serve God. Let us know if we covered everything that you guys wanted to know.
Of course not. It's just like...
let us know if you have more questions. I mean, this... We kind of wrote it this afternoon, the things that we kind of remember through the years, what we did
this
and what we didn't do.
This is just like scratching the surface.
So, send us questions if you have more.
And we can talk about all the stories that we have with Melanie and Milena.
Oh my gosh, we can do maybe a video with just with the stories.
Just the stories. That's...
Because that will take a whole... We have
year.
A lot of... We have a lot of,
yeah.
you know,
but we're very proud
yes.
of who they became.
Oh my gosh.
Milena and Melanie are just amazing young people. They're so ready to go and, you know, do the things that God want them to do. So we sleep well at night.
Yeah, it's just...
If we failed and everything as a parent, right, like being nice and, you know, things that we didn't do, if we failed at everything, just the fact that they know God,
yes.
that's... I think we're done as
yes.
as parents.
Yeah.
That's how I see.
We are truly like proud and every time I look at them and the things that they accomplish in life already, they're mm. so young and they are. I just look it up. I look up because I know it's God and I.
Yeah.
We are so thankful for His faithfulness. So thank you so much, everyone, for watching. Like I said, let us know if you have any more questions. And maybe we'll do another video with the stories, like you said. If you like this video, please give me...
Thumbs up and stuff. I thought...
If you like
my channel...
No.
No.
If you like this video...
Studio, give me two channels.
No.
If you like this
video,
thumbs up...
Stop.
Click on the channel.
If you like
this
video, give me
thumbs
up.
And subscribe to my channel.
And thank you so much. Let us know if you have any questions again. We love you and we appreciate you, every one of you. Thank you so much.